David Faustino.
Hello, this is Andrew Chalmers, the writer and doctor in Doctor Who Dark Journey.
This is Dr. Steve-o.
Everybody, this is the Cavernator.
This is Inspector Gadget.
Hey, what's cracking, y'all? It's your boy, J-Rock.
Good evening, folks. This is James Duval.
This is Jeremy Taggart.
This is Kim Possible.
I'm Chris Holden Reed.
Hey, this is Pat Mastriani from Degrassi.
This is the evil Dr. Bad Vibes.
Again, this is Messy Bear.
And this is Morph from X-Men.
Hey, this is Andrew Gazzess.
This is Sean Gunn.
Hi, this is Robert Carradine.
It's Tammy Stronach from The Neverending Story.
Hey, it's Zach Callison.
Hey, I'm DJ Jenny Rod.
And I'm Neil Young.
I'm Commander Shepard.
Ralph Garman here. You're listening to Droids Canada. You've made an excellent choice. You have chosen wisely.
Warning. Listener discretion is advised.
That means there's a lot of fucking swearing.
Hello.
Fucking iTunes. Oh my god, Dan.
Oh, I'm apologizing beforehand.
Fucking iTunes.
iTunes, I'm sorry.
iTunes, Dan.
I've been slightly under the weather over
He's
the
full
last
of shit.
While. So there's going to be more than one cough throughout this, and I apologize. See?
What the fuck?
iTunes.
Sorry,
iTunes.
What the hell?
Sorry.
Can I be on your podcast? Not anymore.
No.
Coffee, Cofferton.
Oh
Coffee
my
Cofferton?
God!
Oh.
Why are you guys doing this to me today? Like, can't you see I'm tired? I've had a very long week.
It's been a long week. It's going to be a longer night.
It's going to be. Yeah, because this is going to be quite the conversation.
It's going to be quite the conversation.
Conversation of conversations.
That's correct.
The conversation that will change everything we see going forward.
First thing, though, I would like to start with something that came out in the news. Did you hear what happened in Niagara Falls?
The rub and tug?
No, oh. No, not the copy McTuggerton.
Oh, that's the really pretty ice? It was on the news earlier that the ice is really pretty.
Oh, this is even so much better than that. There was some dude who broke into an apartment building. Breaks into the apartment building and he starts wrestling with the guy who lives in the apartment building. And is saying to him, playing with chords there.
So, I am, just ignore
and,
me.
So he's wrestling with this guy saying, I'm apprehending you until they come. Then he gets up and takes off. So the guy who lives in the apartment building calls the cops. When the cops show up, this guy is standing on the roof yelling, I'm fucking Frank Castle.
No.
Legit.
Come on.
Really?
It was, yeah. Look it up. Look it up.
I'm going to look it up.
I'm fucking Frank
I'm
Castle.
I'm going to look it up.
But Frank Castle doesn't apprehend people.
I know, but that's what makes it funny.
He kills them. I mean, killing is easier.
Maybe, you know, for...
Stops overcrowding in jails.
Someone who might be a little on the crazy side, you know, after watching in a, binge-watching 12, 13 episodes of a really, really well-done show...
Right.
They might think this.
Okay. I still think they would have gotten it... Checking. Correct, at least, as to the character development.
Niagara
Kill,
Falls, New York.
Not apprehend.
Niagara Falls, New York.
A man who identified himself to Niagara Falls police as comic book character Frank Castle, after breaking into an apartment where another man slept, was arrested early Thursday morning. The victim, 45, told police he awoke to loud.
There you go. No, wow. With authority. Halfway through the police blotter.
Took your Diet Pepsi, dear. I'm sorry.
That's not a Diet Pepsi. What is that?
It's a Pepsi Mini.
That's
Diet Pepsi Mini.
Because we're saving the calories by getting the smaller can, even though it's diet.
There are no calories.
There's no calories in the diet.
It's because the little cans are cuter.
They are.
And for Todd, it makes him feel like a giant.
My big hand.
Mm-hmm.
Every time I take my pants off, it's how I feel too.
Is it as big as a pop can? Maybe a mini.
Man, it's not about length, man. It's about girth.
Like
it's always
can.
About girth.
Like a pop can.
Thermos. Oh,
Jesus Christ. Mine's a bubba.
I'm going to give you the croissant. Anyways. Points. Oh, you found the bell.
Found the bell.
Oh, good. The bell returns.
See, I just use duct tape and mine goes away.
What goes away?
Never mind.
I'm feeling awkward here.
Kay. Canada's first drag queen on RuPaul. Kay. Is that not exciting? What? No? Okay. Wrong
I thought my joke earlier was pretty funny, though.
Can you continue the police blotter?
I'm trying. The guy was 21, Justin T. Yale, 21, of the village
of... Frank Castle.
No. The village of Johnson City. What the fuck is that? Allegedly grabbed the victim by the arms while saying, "You are being detained until they come."
Being detained by Batman?
I don't know. I was making some Batman voice. What was I doing?
Batman voices.
How about what? Do you remember, though?
Driving through a parking lot in the snow.
No, the person who came into the movie is like, "That's okay. My arm hurts. It's not the pain I need, but the pain I deserve." I'm like, what the fuck's happening beside me, man? I just want to watch this fucking movie.
No one's getting layered popcorn tonight.
Swear to me.
Okay, police blotter.
Satan.
Anyways. Dun-dun-dun. Dan's favorite thing is when I say Satan very demonically.
Satan, Satan.
Oh, Jesus.
I have the best demonic voice.
Oh, wow, he's half mass.
You've been replaced, Todd.
Moving along. The victim pushed Yale off and ordered him to leave. Yale ignored. As he left the apartment, the victim told police he heard glass shatter. No, not Stone Cold Steve Austin. The victim called 911 and waited for officers to arrive at a bar downstairs. At one point... Classy, it's gotta be Buffalo. I mean, yeah. I got attacked. I'm gonna go to have a fucking drink. I gotta get through it.
Buffalo compared to Niagara Falls, New York. Buffalo is like...
Is this Buffalo or Niagara Falls, New York? This is Niagara Falls, New York. Oh, yeah, shit.
Buffalo is like the classy area.
He's going down to get a bucket of chicken or something, and I don't know what they do in Niagara Falls.
Buffalo is classier than Niagara Falls.
Oh, Niagara Falls, New York's a shithole.
Oh, yeah, like, it's really bad there. Just go to the fucking, like, outlet mall, and then you leave. You just turn around.
Oh, I don't think I've ever been.
Oh, shithole.
But the outlet mall's really nice. Yale, who is a member of the swimming and diving team at Niagara University, clearly was on Giggle Pig. I'm kidding. I know the reference, 21 Jump Street.
What's Giggle Pig?
It's 21 Jump Street, movie.
Was shouting from the rooftop when police arrived at 1 a.m. The report said an officer was led into the victim's apartment and noted a shattered window splashed with blood, so he guessed he couldn't find his way, so he headbutt through it. The officer coaxed Yale back into the apartment through the shattered window and handcuffed him. When asked his name, he identified himself as the Punisher. I am fucking Frank Castle, and I am in the fucking Marines. Yale said. This is more exciting than season two. Like, this is... Frank Castle
is real life shit right here.
I'm going to post this on the Facebook page right now. I'm going to make him fucking famous.
Because it is that fucking awesome.
That is fucking hilarious. I have to admit, that was probably one of the funniest fucking things I've read in a long time. It's up there.
I think that's just something you have to do when you commit a crime now. Identify yourself as some sort of amazing random character.
No, Frank Castle. It has to just be Frank
Castle. Just Frank Castle?
Everyone like, I'm Frank Castle.
Starship Troopers TV show with original movie cast.
Rico's Roughnecks.
Casper Van Dien.
Has he done anything other than...
I think he made the third Starship Troopers movie.
What if he's in the third season of Punisher? Wait a minute, it's going to be canceled in 2 months.
If it's not canceled, I literally will fucking...
They're going to give it a month or two.
Netflix has already decided on all the Marvel property items being canceled.
They didn't make the decision.
That was Netflix.
They didn't make the decision.
Right.
Disney made the decision of, Netflix, you're going to cancel this because when they come out with their streaming service, they're going to reboot them all as Disney property.
I don't know. They're denying that pretty hard, aren't they?
Yeah, but it's Disney. They do whatever the fuck they want.
That is true, yes.
I'm just waiting for them to buy WWE.
No.
That'll never happen.
That won't happen.
Hold on. And share. Oh my god.
It is a good story.
Hold on.
I think Disney Channel has only released statements on Loki and Scarlet Witch, right? TV shows.
The Loki show.
Oh, the fangirls. Oh my god, he's so beautiful.
They're pumping a lot of their talking into Disney because of the Galaxy's Edge opening up in June. In California, and then in, I believe, October, Galaxy's Edge is opening in Florida.
Sorry, what is Galaxy's Edge?
Galaxy's Edge is an entire park of Star Wars.
Oh, yes, yes, yes.
Oh, I saw you.
I heard one of their rides is going to be 28 minutes.
28 fucking minutes. You fly in the Millennium Falcon.
For 28 minutes.
Well,
yeah, I saw
that line is going to be awful.
Whenever when Drop Zone came to Canada's Wonderland, it's the shortest ride with the longest line.
30 seconds. Done. But it's going to be...
Man, I last longer than that.
From the whole, like, getting in line process, there's going to be so many things you can do to make the experience 28 minutes. But it's I don't know if it's a 20... Like, you are...
Wait a minute.
Like, something.
This feels like a precursor for a film.
What?
Well, there was 28 days later, 28 months later, 28 minutes later.
Yeah, but all of those movies would not be on the Disney platform.
That is true, yes.
So, should we get to the main course?
Yes.
The main course?
Yes.
We were setting the table.
Setting it. Well, it all started with the song.
Oh, no.
Wait, are we talking about fish tacos again?
The thing you didn't make. Snap. Let's talk about my last weekend. Dan, let's talk about last weekend.
Okay.
Last weekend, I was excited.
Yes.
We were excited.
We were.
We were like, you know what? By golly, we're going to watch a film.
Do not hammer fist the desk.
That was a slap.
Okay.
Hammer fist. This is a slap. All right. This is showing her that you're still in charge.
Like it owes
you money. This is paralyzing her.
Oh. Her?
Well, I mean...
Aren't your office desks female?
The best a man can get. Mm. Oh, no, sorry.
See, she even likes when I spit. Anyways.
Okay.
Hey.
So, your weekend.
So,
your
last weekend.
We're like, you know what? Let's start watching it. And I'm like, no. Wait. Let's go see Glass. Let's get that out of the way.
How was it? I always heard, it was okay. It was good.
I mean, it was good. Like, when you got to the ending, you're like,
that was good.
You're like, here we go. And then the ending happened, and you're like, I don't know.
I did enjoy part of the ending where three of the characters did something together.
Yeah, it's going to ruin the film. There's no way to explain it without ruining the entire
film. Like a three-team high five?
Yeah, it was
a sympathy high five. Sympathy high five.
No, I'm going to leave you hanging.
Oh, you can't do that.
His arm's going to be up the whole podcast now.
Come here, buddy. I got gotcha.
Oh,
thanks, you. Man. You're thanks, welcome. Man. Clearly.
That was a pity high five. I don't think it counts.
It was just as okay.
wet. I was the giver. He's the receiver. I gave the high five. It's no pity high five.
Jen, okay. I hope you're really not listening to this podcast right
I'm
now.
I'm the giver.
Jen, don't
you're
listen to this show.
I pitched.
Your boyfriend caught. Might be... boyfriend. Okay. Oh, my God. Your husband. Can you... downgrade statuses when you're pissed at them when you're married. You'd be like, no, we're not married. You're now moved back to boyfriend.
No. Wouldn't it go back to fiance, then boyfriend? Then
I guess could
friend
that.
With air quotes?
I think go back to friend zone.
Oh, fucking friend zone. Son of a...
And then the acquaintance that you watch from afar on Facebook.
Oh. Facebook creepo.
Anyways, so we got home Friday. Wait, here we go. It was different. We saw Glass on Thursday, right?
We saw Glass on Saturday.
Did we see? Oh, it's Saturday afternoon.
Yeah,
shit.
We did.
So Friday we got home. We're like, here we go. Light them up, motherfucker.
We're not going to sleep till this
first
show
episode,
is done.
First episode. Boom. I'm like, here we go. The table has been set. We are ready for some top-notch killing.
Yes, the head off of the bathroom sink.
Oh, yes. That was a good one.
She made noise. But then ching. She's like, ugh. I'm like, I know. He's dead. There's no other way to put it. Like, you died.
Yeah.
No, it was...
Although okay, the girl wait, who got hit with the sink
so
did
know,
die.
Bullshit
we
on
are,
that.
We are talking about the Punisher.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
We never die. Mentioned what we what you oh. were watching.
Is so, that a fart?
No, it wasn't.
It sounded like the shittle-in.
Shittle-in. Okay, so get on with it. How is fucking Punisher?
Get on with it is what she said. Or is it get on top? No, so we watched the first episode of Punisher, and I'm just fucking blown away. I'm like, yes. Yes.
Well, there were a couple moments where...
Okay, you know what? I'm going to call we're going to get to the part where I call bullshit on Dan's going to defend. So we should just get past that part. I don't know. But, I mean, you had a bunch of new characters brought into the fold. Okay? Mm-hmm. Did you really understand why they needed to be there?
Or remember their names or
I don't
their
even remember.
Backgrounds
the girl...
Amy?
Who's
Which
that?
One was that?
Who's that?
She started as Rachel.
Oh, the blonde kid. Rachel!
See, the one that I think...
God damn it, Batman.
The girl that Frank Castle banged.
The one that
looks super old, like from like she's like Cheshire cat looking. You know, she wouldn't be too bad looking if she didn't look so old.
No, I don't think she like she was just slumped over and kind of defeated looking and sad.
That's what you look like when you work in a bar for a long time.
That's not true. You turned off mine, Dan.
I know, I'm handsome. So,
they
had to bring her in because that's the whole reason why he came back. Because it was a fuck, he did something out of the norm of what he would normally do and got sucked in because of it.
Sure.
So, move on to the next.
No, he got involved with the girl because she was a girl and he wanted to be a savior in that situation. The Amy / Rachel.
Yeah, that's what he does.
So, he went to help her because she called him Rough Road.
Yeah.
And so, he liked her a little bit. The reason he really got into it was because Mopey Girl. Woman with the kid. Do you remember her name?
She always looks so sad.
No, I don't.
Yeah, you don't.
I want to say it's like not Misty.
The one who he brought out for pancakes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
He gave her the pan of cake.
Yeah, and she
extra
got shot.
She got shot, and that really pushed him into wanting the revenge and getting back into the killing.
Syrup was everywhere, I guess you could say. So it was a sticky situation.
I absolutely understand the first episode as a precursor to his motivation for the rest of the season.
Yes.
Not really.
But the Rachel Amy storyline, I found super convoluted.
So, why is she being killed? They took a photo of the guy in the Russian and they're gay. That's what you're going with. We're in 2019, and that's what you're going with.
A senator being gay.
But the senator had absolutely nothing to do with it. It was the family of the senator.
I know it was the family, but the point is like that was it. That was the angle. Really? That's it?
They killed so many people over a photo.
Wow.
And
Russians are crazy.
It seemed... And it took a really long time for it to unfold as to what she was up with.
See, that I did notice. It did take a long time to unfold.
Yeah, if they had come out more quickly about, I was blackmailing the Russian mob, and now they want to kill me, then maybe I could have understood it better, but it just took so long, and I lost interest.
And then with all of this, though, at the same time, they're also developing fucking Billy Russo.
The name you were looking for was Sarah. Sarah.
Sarah!
The one that looks saddled.
Oh, Sarah. The mopey bartender.
Mopey bartender.
Was Sarah.
Like, you're watching this whole show play out, and you're like, okay, cool. Here's Amy. She's got a photo. You're like, okay. They're trying to kill her. Y'all, what's Frank gonna do? Feelings.
Yeah, there's feelings. Lots of feelings.
A lot of feelings.
And I understand developing.
And then weird Billy sex Russo, and digging your finger into like crevices that were scars. Feelings.
The back crevice.
Like, so what happened to her? Like, why did she get thrown? She fell through
the window with her dad.
But it looked like it was. I don't know. That looked pretty gaping.
Like a scar. Like you broke your back.
Yeah, it looked like she was impaled.
No, that's just, I think, back surgery. Yeah.
Well, I'm sorry that her dad tried committing suicide. What?
Yeah, I think he took her.
There was just too much.
No, had a fight with the wife and took her with him, so the kid could not be with the mom.
Yeah, that's
just
actually
decided to take the express route on the way down.
So,
it's faster to get to the ground.
What did you not like about it?
I just felt like it was dry as fuck. Like, I mean, I felt like I was watching. I almost wanted to watch Luke Cage season 2 to cleanse the palate.
Did you? Were you expecting Iron Fist season 1 more interesting? Were you expecting more action?
Yes, absolutely. That's the Punisher.
So you wanted John Wick?
No, I wanted the Punisher. Have you ever read a Punisher comic?
No.
No feelings. Death.
No, but it wasn't even that he had feelings. I understand him having feelings and communicating those to other characters, but the fact is, it was, like you said, dry. It took a really long time. And I feel like they didn't have their story boards figured out because it was all over the place.
It was. There was a lot of things that was going on, but I did feel that the not being a non-Punisher comic person, I'm doing air quotes just so that people can see me.
They can't see you, Dan.
I know they can't.
Dan, they can't see you. Dan, they can't see you.
Being a non-Punisher person, non-Punisher comic book reader, what I noticed from that was the younger girl Amy became almost like the daughter to him, that he was protective of her,
right?
Which is the way that whole character arc kind of went. Meanwhile, while this whole we got to figure out Billy Russo,
Oh, God.
I would have liked to have
totally
seen
ruined
more,
that character while we were at it.
I would have liked to have seen more chaos with him.
Yes.
Okay, have you seen what Jigsaw looks like?
In the comic book world, no.
I was so disappointed with his
scars. Or even the
scars.
Ray Stevenson Punisher film?
The Ray Stevenson Punisher film, no.
Warzone? Oh,
no,
Lord.
But disregard all of that. I know nothing about Punisher. I have not read
Neither
any comic
I
books or any previous TV shows or movies except for the Netflix version. And I was extremely disappointed in his scars and his story. Like, I felt like he was just kind of dragged along.
Yeah, see, that looks like a deadite.
Pretty much, his face got... Well, that's an extreme version of it, but that's the Billy Russo from Punisher Warzone. But, I mean, his face was fucking carved up good.
Well,
and this movie, it's like, have a scar.
They still had to keep him pretty, though.
No, that was it. It was obvious that they just wanted
and
to keep him pretty.
And then even the ending when they killed off his character, you're like, I have no closure. I felt like it was just like, how do we wrap this up? He just walks over, puts two in him, and walks away. Oh, okay, cool. That works.
All of his motivation and everything was gone, and he just became a bank robber.
So you're saying the ending was just Frank Castle shooting him and then going, no!
That's lazy writing, and that would be Star Wars Episode 3, sir.
100%.
So what is something you really liked about it?
Yeah, Dan.
I did think the action sequences they had were good.
I like how you put that in. They had.
Yes.
The scene when he goes into the gym to fight all the
Oh, that was pretty
sick.
That
was fucking awesome.
Dude, when he fucking
just like myself, why wouldn't you just bring in a gun and shoot? But he doesn't. He just decides I'm going to fight all these people.
Cuz he's a badass. It's Frank Castle.
And he does it really well.
There's
two celebrities in that scene. Two.
What's UFC?
Yep.
Keith
Dean Jardine.
Yes, that's what I thought. The toughest out of them.
And the what's his name? The Russian. Fuck. He was in WWE for a while too. He's the guy that had the goatee in it. He was the one they took the 45 plate upside the face.
Kurgan?
No, not Kurgan. I have to look it back up. He left WWE, got in shape. Like, he was big.
So, what the fuck's his name? The priest guy.
Oh, John, not Shepherd. I had looked it up earlier.
Did it start with a P, Parrish?
John Pilgrim.
Pilgrim. That's it.
He's a badass character in comic books, too, apparently.
Was he in... Batman?
She said that.
I think he was the guy who... He was one of the bad guys Dark Knight Rises.
He was one of the, goons.
Oh,
goons
for Bane.
Yeah.
Gotta start somewhere, buddy.
Well, I know him from a short-lived TV show called Dirt with Courtney Cox, but that was years and years ago.
Courtney Cox.
It doesn't taste like Cox unless I say
so
it tastes like
Cox. What do you like think Courtney Cox breast? What's her best role? What is her best role? Courtney Cox?
Oh,
Courtney Cox.
You know what? In that short-lived TV show, Dirt, she was amazing in it.
Dirt.
What about you, Tom? What would you say?
Courtney Cox. I don't know. I don't like Courtney Cox.
She was really good in 3,000 Miles to Graceland,
too. Wasn't she in Ace Ventura?
Yes.
The first one.
Bruce Springsteen video. Done. She was
boss?
A dancing girl.
She was.
You would have been laughing when I was at the hockey game 2 weekends ago. You know what song I played for you?
Shit.
Italian
Did you get
fight song
for this one?
The Italian fight song.
C'è la luna mentamara, ma mi ramarita. Oh, you played
Glory Days. The Italian fight
That's
song.
When you hear like when you're a kid and you
not
hear
anymore.
Glory Days blazing like blaring, and then you see lights of a Trans Am pop up. You know shit's going down.
Oh really?
Oh fuck yeah.
And Uncle Tony shows up.
Oh fucking Uncle T.
Tony. Because he's got to ward off the Maloki.
No, see, I thought Punisher was a good blend of story,
but
character building, which I do believe happened. I didn't like the build on Russo. I think that he could have been more chaotic than he was. He just seemed broken.
The psychological part of it, though.
The psychoness of Frank Castle seeming like he just wants to go in and die, but he doesn't because he doesn't die. He does the killing. I thought that was great. I thought I called out earlier when I was first watching it, that the psychiatrist girl was going to be behind Russo. That was easy to pick up.
Oh, that was super easy.
Super
Plus
easy
her demise of being thrown out a window.
Yeah.
That was
what a way to die.
Foreshadowed like crazy.
No, she didn't die, didn't she? I thought she survived.
She did, but being thrown out a window
being
at some
out
point.
Window again, yeah.
I saw that
Must
coming
out. Must traumatic coming out of the second
but
floor window.
I did
I think it was a third.
Even with all the things that were going on, I really enjoyed it. It was
better
a
she
great
got
show.
Impaled by a fucking change
there,
meter.
There were definitely moments that I enjoyed, especially the action scenes. I agree, they were really, really well done.
The action scenes when they were there, I agree.
I just found the story lacking, and I need to have good story.
They did a whole fucking episode, which was a nod to Assault on Precinct 13. Did you ever see that film?
No.
Great film. Absolutely great film. When they
Oh, was that when they were stuck in the in the jail?
That's okay. What the whole nod was for. And you're like, okay, this is cool, but then you're like, these characters, I don't care about them. There's nothing there that makes me want to even invest any time. Like, oh yeah, this cop got shot.
They really
He's
tried.
Just gonna try and stick through it anyways. Dude, you got shot in the gut. You ain't doing shit.
But they did. They really tried and kind of heavy-handedly to push characters.
All they had to do was get Frank Castle to run out the back door with an AR-15 and he would suddenly put down like 50 guys by himself without taking a hit. He's running through the forest.
He got shot in the ass, remember?
Oh, yes. He did get shot in the buttock. I believe it was the right buttock.
In the buttocks?
Yes. The upper buttocks.
He's a cheeky bastard, they say.
Something jumped up and bit me in the buttocks.
Yeah, it's all.
No, but like his one-legged friend who had a girlfriend, and they really tried to push that story of him having a normal life with his girlfriend, but he helped Frank Castle instead. And it was just like, I don't care. And
it made him more human. It made him more human.
They could have shot him in the head, and I wouldn't have felt anything. But I am kind of cold-hearted.
I got something for Dan, but we'll do that and we'll do that later.
I think we're gonna have to agree to disagree on the whole Punisher. I thought it was great,
Dan.
I think we're agreeing.
I know AJ's not here, but you don't have to pull an AJ on me.
I'm not. I was looking forward to the next episodes.
I literally after I think the third episode is when we really felt checked out, and we're like, "Why are we watching this? We'll just put it on." And I found us more on our phones.
Than I've been on any TV show in a while.
First night, four episodes straight through.
Six.
Six. We got through six, and then finally I was like, that's it. I'm going to bed.
We went to bed. Then we woke up the next day. We watched two episodes. And then we went and saw Glass. And then we came back. We got to finish it. And we got to episode 10.
Which would we rather do right now? Watch Punisher? Or I could clip my toenails?
So what would you say is better? Punisher, Season 2, or Titans?
Titans.
That's my next one I'm starting.
I just started that one.
How far have you gotten? Are you just still where we left off?
Yeah, two episodes.
Good job. I have like halfway through episode 9 and then there's 10 and 11 because I was going to finish it and then she's like, I want to watch Titans. I'm like, well,
I didn't watch it then.
He is rewatching it with me. Well, whenever she gets around to watching it.
Well, I've been watching Arrow at home.
Yeah.
So I only watch Titans when I'm here.
She's trying to binge all of Arrow. That's 23 episodes of seven seasons.
I finished season one.
I've never watched one episode of Arrow.
Well, Arrow's not for everybody.
Arrow's an interesting show. I'm really happy with, what's his name? Colin...
Mockery?
No.
Colin Mockery.
The guy from Teen Wolf.
Whose line is it anyways?
Arsenal.
Styles.
She's thinking of the guy that's gay.
Yes, he came out as gay a couple years ago.
Kevin Spacey.
No. His name starts with a C, I'm sure of it.
We talked about it the other day, C-E-V-I-N. Like in detail and everything.
Yeah, he's Arrow's apprentice, apparently, in future seasons.
Yeah,
and he's dating his sister in
could
season one.
Could you spell
one.
Kevin with a C? C-E-V-I-N? What's your name? Kevin.
You can apparently spell a name any way you want.
With a dollar sign.
Dollar signs, apostrophes, what doesn't even make sense. Hell, someone even had a name of an exclamation mark.
It all started with Prince.
Well,
what, his name was a symbol?
Changed his name to a symbol.
I don't think he legally did, though.
What's that?
I don't think he legally did.
I think he told people that he did.
What was the best name change? Chad Ochocinco? Chad Johnson, the football player,
yeah,
he legally changed his name to Ocho Cinco.
I remember
because
that.
He wanted it to say Ocho Cinco on his jersey, but he changed his first name to Ocho and his last name to Cinco, so his jersey would just say Cinco on it. So then he rechanged his name to Chad, last name Ocho Cinco.
Well, that's
so fucking
determined guy right there.
Well, fucking, he's
Ocho Cinco. Last name? I don't understand the last name.
85. Ocho Cinco is 85 in Spanish. That was his number.
Okay.
And Meta World Peace.
Basketball? Oh, I remember that one. Yeah.
Fucking right. Hey, Meta, what's up?
Oh my God.
World Peace.
I looked into changing my name once, and it was so much work.
What would you want to change it to?
Oh, I was going to change it to my grandmother's maiden name, my last name.
It's Destiny. Charisma. Star.
Unique.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
That's spelled with three S's.
Karma with four K's.
If you could change your name, Ty, what would it be?
Ugh.
Well, it would be... oh, I had a good name, too. I'm stealing it from fucking Edge the Rustler, though. Dalton Hardcastle? Or,
Dalton?
I can't remember what it was, but it was like the funniest... It's like, I couldn't think of a wrestler's name, so I took a porn star name. I'm like, Hardcastle, that's good. That is good.
What would your porn name be?
Well, I don't know.
No, it's
fucking
your,
Frank Castle.
No, it's your the first Impaler. Pet's name and the street you grew up on.
Max Alberta?
Smokey Demude.
Nice.
No.
Okay, Elizabeth, we're waiting.
If it was my daughter... Oh, fucking... Oh, no. Mine would be Ruby Noodles Crossing.
Ruby Noodles Crossing?
Yes.
That's pretty no, good.
Or Ruby Noodles Wilson.
Good job, guys.
I like Ruby Crossing Noodles better. Wilson. Ruby Noodles Crossing. I like
it's
that
fucking
better.
Embarrassing!
A little bit.
At least it's not Ruby Noodle.
If I fail my Rebo test, I'm going to do the boomerang.
What's the boomerang?
The boomerang.
What's the boomerang?
Oh, you weren't there. That's right. He wasn't there for Letterkenny. It's the coach.
Have you watched more Letterkenny?
No.
No?
I think I left off where you left off. After one. Fart book.
I think there's a third episode of season one or something, yeah.
No, they were to explain all the different ways of kicking the garbage can when you're pissed off.
Oh, yeah, okay.
So the boomerang is when you leave the room and then come back and kick it. And, you know, it's fucking embarrassing. So anyways, back to Punisher.
Yes.
So we can wrap up this episode.
Is there anything else left to say about it other than I thought it was pretty damn good?
Well, here's the thing. They're really pushing for a third season. Vincent D'Onofrio said, you know what, if Daredevil's not coming back, I'll go to Punisher and we'll just start that storyline. And that is a huge, huge story.
Yeah, but...
It won't happen.
No.
Because we want it.
Okay, what did the star just sign on to?
Who? Oh, John Barathol is going to Sopranos.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
As a movie, it's not a show.
Oh, it's a movie.
Oh, I thought it's a show.
It's a movie. Okay.
Well, then that's
they started
so it
shooting.
Come back.
Yeah,
and Walking Dead fans can rejoice because they started shooting the Rick Grimes movie.
Oh, yep. He gets three, right?
Gets three. And then he'll officially be retired and go back to England and have
be
some
in Love
crumpets.
Actually,
too. What?
He's going to star in Love Actually, too, isn't he?
They are going
to
do...
Hold up the card signs.
Ugh, Cecil did that joke for an airport.
They're going to do a... is it just going to be him and... what's her name? Garbage Lady? The Garbage Lady.
No, they'll probably introduce new characters.
Well, I know. There'll be new characters, but it'll be a whole new...
Oh, Garbage Lady.
Yeah. The one who brought him on the chopper.
I don't know.
Get to the chopper.
Yes, the chopper.
I think they hear the chopper, but anyways.
Well,
no, because maybe their ears were ringing from the explosion.
Oh yeah, I did hear that theory that
by shooting a piece of dynamite.
Jesus,
no, I did hear. Did you hear that theory that the reason zombies keep sneaking up on them is because their ears are shot from gunfire?
That could be correct. I mean,
yeah, it's because one of the complaints is why are zombies keep sneaking up on people? I mean, seriously, do they not hear them? And so the theory came out that no, they don't hear them.
Mind blown.
I think that's really it.
Well, I think it's a good place to leave with minds blown from an Ellie
true.
Fact.
I mean,
what?
That is true.
I think he's preoccupied. I just hear clicks.
Yeah, he's clicking on something.
Clickety click.
You and I could talk.
Clickety click.
What should we talk about?
How about Billy Idol? Oh, wait a second. Shotgun? So, this has to do about a wedding. Hey, little sister, shotgun. It's a nice day to say bye-bye.
It's a nice day for a white wedding. It's a nice day to start again. Hey, little sister, what's your fascination? Hey, little sister, shotgun, oh yeah.
Hey, little sister, who's your Superman? Hey.